quite scratchy at the limit, so you saw what happened, okay? I'll move on before I do anything stupid on that. Okay, right, yeah, this is where we go. This is, now what we use here, we have a 3D capacitive reader in our sensor, which is 3D capacitive, okay? Normally, readers on biometric readers or all metal readers are 2D, okay? And as you can see, the amount of data or information that gets picked up because of that is your 2D and here's your 3D. It really does fill up the complete sensor of what it's looking for, okay? It's where the market's going. We're not the only ones that have a 3D sensor in there, but we are one of the few. Not everyone has that, okay? We're certainly the only people that have a 3D sensor in the car. Sensor in the car. Okay, so this is it, okay? This sheet shows you what's actually being looked at, what's being taken from the sensor in the temporal. There's the 2D. You can see that all it's doing is taking the distance of the lines and the distance between each other. This is just a template of what we feel it looks like. Obviously magnified many, many times. Okay? So, this is what our sensor looks for. You can see it's greater detail. It's looking for the distance between the lines, certain points, distance between there, and the depth, and the image, and then just a far better image picture of what you get from 2D. Okay? That's a great slide to steal from me, okay? When you get the presentation and put it into your presentations, if that's what you do, you use that slide because it really does promote the reader. Okay. Just to give you a bit more of an idea of what I was talking about there, okay? Just reading everything, absolutely everything, is that your full fingerprint can offer that's unique to you. That's the capture. Again, this again tells you why you should use as many fingerprint templates in one go. Because again, as I said, if you're only using one template on one finger, it's only going to be looking for there. On the next finger, looking for there and looking for there. So if you're using one template, you've got to make absolutely sure that part of your fingerprint is on that reader every single time. Okay, it sounds easy in the bathroom, but it's not that difficult. Something you can think of so good. Okay, so that's. That's why you do that. There you go, just tells you what I was just talking about there. Okay, very near the end now. What this shows you is the enrollment process. This is a hard document, okay, so you can actually get this. We have this on video as well. Video is a lot better. It just shows you what I was doing earlier on, how to enroll the sample. I would suggest that you have this. And I'd also suggest that when you get the card, when you get your own demo cards, it's kind of sound really sad, but sit at home tonight or whatever and just practice enrolling your template onto the card. Okay? It's going to be a demo card, so it will automatically come off. Okay? No problem there. And then you'll get to use it. The biggest problem that we have as why when we sell our card is getting people to have the confidence to enroll their template into a card. For some reason, people get panicked. So a lot of times I've actually sat down with engineers and actually helped them through the enrollment process. That's an offer service that we offer you. If you have a customer and you think they're going to have problems, let me know. And I'm more than happy to come back down to South Africa, especially in the summer, in this whole winter. And help you guys out, so I will do that, okay? So just bear that in mind. Okay, there's just a list of the part numbers you'll get, and that's it. And there you go, that's it. And any questions on what I've said today?
Is there a technical document explaining the acceptance rate or the failure to acceptance rate? And whether it's FIPS and all these other kinds of things, compliance and so on?
Yeah, compliance, yes. Acceptance to failure rate is not an official document, because obviously that's information that we don't want to broadcast, that we keep to ourselves. I will tell you that it's extremely high. The positive side of it, not the acceptance of failure. You talk about false positives and false negatives. Yeah. Yeah, you can hear my reluctance to push that out there because we don't want that being known, but it's extremely good. You know, you're not going to get any problems. Okay. The only problems that you will get when people say, oh, this car is rubbish, it doesn't work, is because they're not allowing the sensor to read it well enough. You see how easy it is, I'll just put it off up on the paper. There you go. That's weird. That's how easy it is to fail. So it's looking for me again. There you go, I've taken me time. What people do, they're rushing up and go, oh, look. I mean, it's just so just rush up and they say, what's going on? The car will remain open, will remain live, with the green light there. You can see that's gone on for about 10 seconds. That can be adjustable if you want to. Some customers don't want the car to remain open for more than 5 seconds. That's their jurisdiction. Personally, I think that's too short. I know it's not my decision. So what we can do, we'll adjust it if it's a worthwhile project. But normally, we say between 8 and 12 seconds that it remains live for. And I think that's plenty. It's not too long, it's not too short. Okay, any other questions? Okay, well, we'll now just show you the logical access card I was still talking about, the thinner one. And as I said, this is used for poor logical access, logging onto your PC. Okay. Right, so this is it here. As you see, it's a standard size access control card. This one I have here is MyFair Classic technology. This card only works in smart card frequency 13.56 MHz. It doesn't work in 125 kHz. Okay, that's the only card that works with both technologies. This one is 13.56 only. So this card is used for logical access. The enrollment process is exactly the same. The technology inside is exactly the same. The biometric sensor. Exactly the same as what I've already spoken about. So I'm not going to go over that again. Two flashing lights that you have here, I've replicated on here with these two white dots. I don't know if you can see them, but they are there, believe me. And what happens is you have your desktop reader. I just happen to have an identity reader here, OmniKey, obviously well known brand of reader, HID again. OmniKey work just as well with us. So what's this? This is used for securely logging onto your laptop or your PC. At the moment, we promote a French company called Islog with their software. Okay. Now, the only reason we promote that is because that's the only company that we've currently worked with for logical access. The only reason we don't promote anyone else is because we haven't physically tested it with our product. Okay. It's going to work. Okay. As long as the card can be read by the software will interact with it, because it is exactly the same as a standard access control card once it's switched on. So, you plug your laptop, your reader into your laptop or a USB port, and you simply put the card onto the reader like that. The reader, it takes the power from the reader, and again, all you're doing there is doing your enrollment process. That's pretty normal. Okay? Now, what happens is, with going back to wall-mounted readers, using this card for wall-mounted readers, there is a couple out there that do work. One, again, just one just happens to be another French company called Steed, STID. Okay. So their reader provides enough power for long enough to power this card. And it's, again, simply you're going up to the reader there. This one hasn't quite got the same read range as the battery you're powered on. You've got to be pretty close to it, to quite a touch of it, to get the power. Harvest from there. Okay. I'm working with a company in Turkey in Istanbul, We've actually got a handheld reader that gives enough power to hold this card. Okay. Now, I was in August, I think it was, last in Abu Dhabi with the Abu Dhabi Police Force and the Ministry of Interior, and they, being the UAE, they want something smart and flash. They didn't like this, which is fine. They love this, which is also fine. And then they wanted to use this with their police force in this instance for doing spot checks, roadside checks, so people saying, are you who you say you are? Okay. And with this reader in Turkey, we can now offer them a solution to be able to do that, which is tremendous. So they're going to be using our card, this card here, with electric technology inside it. The Ministry of Interior, which is the equivalent of Home Office, also did the same kind of thing, want to use that card with wall mounted readers. Now, I've seen this reader from Turkey. I certainly didn't put it on a wall, but I've seen it, and they're going to do it. And it's going to look funny, but that's not going to do it, but it's up to them. They're paying the bills. So, that again, so this card can be used as access control, but I would be very cautious, very aware of what you say about this card when it comes to access control. Again, you have my contact details, please. Any discussions with this card access control, let's discuss it, let's talk about it first before we commit to the end user to what we can and can't do. Let's not overemphasize the expectations.
What's the price difference between the two? See that the other is
It's fairly minimal. We're not talking, it's less than 10%, it's a single figure percentage difference. I can't remember, that's what I'm trying to deflect it off to off cloud. Do you have any prices here?
We did something, but yeah.
Right, okay, fine, yeah. What we do say, in the UK and Europe, I suggest as an MSRP to the end user, something might reach about $55. So that's going to be different over here, okay? And the pricing structure is affected because of that. Okay. Whilst we're on the subject of pricing, let's not walk away from a project just because you think we're overpriced. We will negotiate, and we're going to have a discussion as we've had in this week. For larger projects, is there going to be any discount for large projects, etc., etc.? The answer to that is yes. We haven't sat down and discussed it, but we will, I'm sure. Don't lose a project on prices. That's what I'm trying to say there. Come and discuss it, and we will, I'm sure we'll come to some sort of agreement. Any other questions? Okay. I've explained everything well. Are you happy that you can enroll a template, your own template, onto the card? Are you happy that you can go out and sell this? I have many sales tools for you if you want to use them. Please, if you do, contact me and I will email them to you. I will support you. If you have a question, just either pick the phone up or send me an email. I'll respond to it as soon as I can. Okay, well, thank you. Thank you very much for your time. I appreciate it. And as I said, we've had some refreshments out here. But I'll hand over to Adam to close. And then, whilst we're talking or having some food, if you've got any questions, you might come up to you, approach me, we'll have a chat. Thanks, guys. Thank you.
Okay, I would like to thank you. Thanks to Mr. John Lowes for coming all the way from UK and spending some time with us to do this wonderful presentation. All right, thank you so much. Thank you.
Sorry, which one?